It's fashionable to say by critics of communism that whatever you say about communism, not only was it a humanitarian catastrophe, but economically it doesn't work. Unfortunately, we have today a case of Communist Party in power, which economically not only it works, but it created the only genuine economic miracle of the last decades. Are you aware what China achieved in the last decades? Forget about British industrialisering or whatever. I don't think there was ever in the history of humanity such a creation of new wealth. They lifted out of poverty 300-400 million people, such an economic boom as China did it. Now you will say, I suspect that I know. Yes, because they allowed capitalism. That's not enough. I spoke with a person who was, I don't want to put him into trouble, so I will not tell his name, close to the daughter of Deng Xiaoping. And he told me that just after the death of Mao Zedong, he spoke with her, the daughter, who was, you know, when Deng Xiaoping was dying, he was barely able to speak, and she was the only one who was able, like, to follow. And she said that when Deng Xiaoping was dying, some high nomenclatura members came to him and asked him this, kissing the ass question, like, what is the greatest thing you did? Everybody expected he will say opening up China. He said, no, that I resisted at that point with economic reforms, also full Western democracy. That I said, no, stop, the party has to remain in power. And I think, unfortunately, I'm not praising, I don't think we should become like China. I think that, unfortunately, he was right. The successful formula is precisely new authoritarian capitalism. It's another form of what you quoted with Nancy Fraser, this progressive, but this time it's not progressive, authoritarian neoliberalism. Economically, full participation in the free world market, politically an authoritarian regime. My right-wing friend, but who is not an idiot, Peter Sloterdijk, asked an interesting question. If 50 years from now they will be building monuments around the world, to which person they will build it from our epoch? Sloterdijk's answer is Lee Kuan Yew, the founder of modern Singapore, who invented this formula of very successful economic authoritarian, economically capitalist but authoritarian regime. And so what's the achievement of China? And I think China is even our main danger, to avoid the idea that I'm praising China. The left in 20th century hated mostly, if I simplify it a little bit, two things. On the one hand, this pure, brutal, unbridled liberal capitalism, and at the same time, a strong authoritarian state. What China did is to combine the two in an extremely successful way. And are we aware of the irony of what goes in China? The most dangerous profession, forget about, you can be for capitalism, even for Western ideas, they tolerate it. The really dangerous thing today in China is to be a Marxist obsessed with ecological concerns. Then you know that they are now serially arresting Marxist students there, and so on and so on. So I am not, first, I don't want to stigmatize China. Often we project things onto China, but we are already doing them in a more subtle way. For example, you know that in China you already have this form of digital control, and it's developing in such a fast way that ideally, but they are almost there. Every citizen has it's in the state, of course, computers, his, her, their let's say, identity, where his good points, bad points are noticed. For example, if you are convicted of something, if you engage in dissident activity, you lose points, or blah, blah, blah. And this has very concrete consequences. I read somewhere, these are official statistics, that in 2018, 30 million people were prohibited buying fast train tickets and plane tickets because they're patriotic standard or whatever was too low. Now, my point is what? It's easy to make fun of this. Yeah, yeah, China, primitive Orientals. If there is something to learn from all this Google, Cambridge Analytica and so on, problem is that we are doing the same things. And the big problem is what to do against this tendency. This new authoritarian capitalism. In India, it's the same, Narendra Modi. This combination of economically successful capitalism with authoritarian, usually religiously or ethnically nationalist ideology dominating. And we are there. Did you read what happened a couple of days ago in Poland, in a northern city? I'm not saying it's a central event, but it's a clear sign. There was the first after the good old, I mean it ironically, Nazi times, public burning of the books. Local Catholic priests brought on a market in front of a church a big package of books, some Harry Potter novels and so on, and they burned them publicly. And media just took notice of it and so on and so on.